Today we're going to learn how to solve equations with non-integer exponents. Wouldn't that be fun? Okay, so what does a non-integer exponents mean? A non-integer would be a rational number. So let's look at a rational number. A non-integer, an integer is a 0, no, 1, 2, 3, 4. Remember, 0 is a whole number, okay? So non-integer would be something like 3/4, 2/3, 1/5. All these are rational or non-integer. Now, what does it mean by a non-integer exponent? We know what an exponent is. X raised to 2. 2 is your exponent, right? So now, instead of x squared, what if we had x raised to 2/3 or 3/4 or 1/5 or any of that? Those would be a non-integer equation. So we're going to learn how to solve some of them. So let's take a problem. Let's say x raised to 3/2 equals 27. This is my equation given to me, and we're going to learn how to solve this for the value of x. So we're going to solve for x, okay? Now, remember one thing. Before we go ahead and do this, let's learn something about reciprocals. What is a reciprocal of 3/2? It's flipping this, that's 2/3, right? What is a reciprocal? You bring the 2 up and 3 down, so you get 2/3. What happens when you multiply this? You get a 1, an absolute number 1. So reciprocal of anything will, and you multiply them, you'll get 1. So we are going to use that rule. So we're saying x raised to 3/2 raised to 2/3. Now remember, this is math, so whatever you do on one side, you need to do on the other side. So I have raised this to 2/3 and we raised this to 2/3. Now the rules of exponents say that when you raise the exponents one after another, you multiply them. And again, we leave this as it is for a minute right now. What happens here? You get the value of x. So x is nothing but 27 raised to 2/3. Now what does that even mean? Now you can use your calculator and plug this in, or we can actually solve it. So let's solve it. When I have 2/3, how do I write that into radical? That means the cube root. Remember, the 3 comes here, of 27, and the whole thing is squared. This is still the value of x. What is the cube root of 27? That means what number, when I multiply by itself, gives me 27. So that's 3. 3 times 3 is 9. Times 3 is 27. So that's 3 squared. And therefore, 3 squared is nothing but 9. So x equals 9. That is the answer for this equation. Let's try another one. Let's say we have an equation like x minus 2 the whole raised to 1/5 equals negative 2. Now remember, we do not like exponents which are non-integers. So how do I get rid of them? I multiply this whole thing by the reciprocal. And the reciprocal of this is nothing but 5/1. And remember, whatever I do one side, I always do on the other side. Once I do this, I get x minus 2, because remember, the 5's cancel out. That is equal to minus 2 raised to 5. How do I get minus 2 raised to 5? Again, you can put in your calculator, or this is nothing but minus 2 how many times? 5 times. Now, because this is an odd number, your answer is going to be a negative 32. Check that out. So I get x minus 2 is negative 32. Have I found x? No, I'm going to add 2 on both sides. And therefore, my answer is minus 30. So again, for this problem, your value of x is minus 30. Let's try a last problem. Let's say I have a problem, 64 raised to 3, x 3 raised to 4 minus 125 equals 0. What do I do in a problem like this? So the first thing is I isolate my x. So what do I do for that? I add the 125 on both sides. And what is math then? Equal to signs, everything has to be balanced. You can't do one thing on one side and this could cancel. So you get 64x raised to 3/4 equals 125. My x is still not alone, so I divide by 64 on both sides. I get x 3/4 equals 125 over 64. Now we have x by itself. So what am I going to do? I'm going to raise this whole thing by 4/3 on both sides. And then I cancel this and I get my x by itself. What does that mean? Again, I'll get the cube root, because remember the 3 is in the denominator, of 125 over 64 the whole raised to 4. Now what is the cube root of 125? 125, what is the cube root of 125? Again, what number when I multiply by itself by 3 times will give me 125, which is 5, and for this is 4. You can use your calculator to do this part, or you can actually do it. And this number is going to be 625 over 256. And that's your answer. This is how you're going to find how